Very good morning, students. Students, today we will do pronouns. I know already you are aware of pronouns. What are pronouns? We will definitely say pronouns are words that are used in place of nouns. Now, why do we have to use pronouns? Now, children, when in a paragraph, we are writing few sentences. Suppose we use some nouns and again we repeat the same noun. It becomes very monotonous and it is not a proper way to write. I give you an example. Suppose I talk about a girl called Riya. Riya is a girl. Riya is 10 years old. Riya lives in Bharuch. Riya studies in Balhati school. We all love Riya. Now see how many times I am repeating the name Riya. It becomes very monotonous and it is not the proper way to repeat the single noun again and again or the particular noun again and again. So, with the use of pronouns, we can write in this way or we can speak in this way. Riya is a girl. Riya, instead of Riya is 10 years old, we can say she is 10 years old. She lives in Bharuch. She studies in Balhati Public School. The people or everybody loves Riya. Instead of saying everybody loves Riya, we can say everyone or everybody loves her. So you can see we are using the pronouns like she and her. Now they are all personal pronouns like I, you, he, she, it. They are all personal pronouns. They are used for subjects. When we are talking about a singular person, in the first person we say I. But when it is plural, we say we. Because we means, children remember this thing, we means I am there. And with I, there is somebody else or some other people are there. Means it is plural in noun. So when we are using for, when we are talking about myself or I am talking about myself, I use the word I. When we are talking about I and with I there are someone else, then it is we. When we are talking about second person, you. You can be singular also, you can be plural also. I can say you, Priya, come and meet me after the class. Or you students, let us go to the playground to play. So I am talking about one, also you, when I am talking about many. Second person. For third person, when we are talking about a man or a boy or somebody masculine, male, then it is he. When we are talking about woman, girl, them or female or feminine, then it is she. And when we talk about something which we don't know whether it is a female or a male, then we use it for single. And for plural, we use they. Let's say we say, we are sitting in the classroom and studying pronouns. They, when we are talking about many, they are in the playground playing football. Okay, so these are all subject pronouns. Now we have object pronouns. Like I said, everybody loves her. So when we are talking about object, subject is the talk about whom I am talking. She, he, it, I, you, we, they are all subject pronouns. And when we are using for object pronoun, we use, like I have written here, me, us, for singular, when we are talking about I. You gave the book to me. when we are talking about we means plural, us. They are going to picnic with us. Okay? Now you doesn't change, you remains you everywhere, whether it is subject or object, singular or plural. Then her, person when we are talking. As I told you, we, she, it, and then if it is he, we write him. He went to classroom, give the book to him. She gave me a present. I thanked her. So it is her. It remains it. Like I am talking about the table. It is broken. Give the table to or give the food to it. It means maybe an animal which is standing in front of my door, but I don't know whether that animal is a female or a male. And when we are talking about plural, they are playing football, as I just told you, and them. Like I said, we gave food to the beggars. They thanked us. We also gave some clothes to them. So I'm talking about them. So this is object pronoun. So these are all our personal pronouns. When we are talking about personal pronouns. So we use I for singular, we for plural. In second person, we use you for singular as well as plural. For third person, when there is talking about male, he, female, she, and when we don't know any gender, like neuter gender, it is it. We don't know whether it's a boy or a girl, or we are talking about a thing which has no gender, like when we are talking about things like fan, light, table, chair, the blackboard, or the pencil, or whatever. This is the green board. It is used for writing. Okay, so this is it. Now, they is used for plural.